Today's case is a testicular tumor in a 62-year-old gentleman. Here is the gross cut section, revealed a gray-white solid lesion, relatively soft in consistency, and there are some areas of hemorrhage. Let us see the microscopy. Here is a diffuse tumor with some edematous area. And here we can identify three types of cells in high power. One is having the size of mature lymphocytes and condensed chromatin. These small cells, which are having the size of mature lymphocyte and condensed chromatin. Then majority are intermediate cells, which are having eosinophilic cytoplasm, granular chromatin, and approximately 15 to 18 micrometer in size. And there are some very large cells or giant cells which are having this cord-like or filamentous chromatin. So again, three types of cells: small cells having the size of mature lymphocyte and condensed chromatin, intermediate cells having moderate cytoplasm, and granular chromatin, and some very large cells or giant cells, 18 to 100 micrometer in diameter. Sometimes there may be significant stromal edema, which may produce a pseudocystic appearance. Here again, we can see the three kinds of cells: small cells with condensed chromatin, intermediate cells with granular chromatin, and some large cells, 80 to 100 micrometer in diameter. This combination of small, intermediate, and giant cells is seen in spermatocytic tumor. Previously, they were known as spermatocytic seminoma. Medial age of occurrence is more than in classic seminoma. It is approximately 52 years. Generally, prognosis is good. Radical orchidectomy will be curative. But in approximately 6% of the cases, sarcomatous transformation may occur. If sarcomatous transformation occurs, the prognosis will be poor. There will be poor response to therapy. Regarding IHC, they are positive for SALF4 and membranous positivity for CD117. And they are negative for classic seminoma markers like OCT3x4, placental alkaline phosphatase or PLAP. So they are positive for SALF4, CD117, etc. and negative for OCT3x4, PLAP, etc. Mitotic figures can be seen. Here we are seeing one mitotic figure. Atypical mitosis also can be seen. Regarding the staging of testicular tumor, if tumor is confined to testis and no lymphovascular invasion is seen, that is T1 stage. Here we can see one endothelial lined vessels and a tumor emboli attached to the endothelial lining. If tumor is limited to testis, without lymphovascular invasion it becomes T1, and if tumor limited to testis with the lymphovascular invasion, it becomes T2. T3, if tumor invades spermatocord with or without lymphovascular invasion, and if tumor invades scrotum with or without lymphovascular invasion, it becomes T4. Then TX, primary tumor, cannot be assessed. T0, when no evidence of primary tumor. T1, tumor confined to testis without lymphovascular invasion. And if lymphovascular invasion is there and tumor confined to testis, it is T2. T3, when tumor invades spermatocord, and T4 when it invades scrotum. That's all about spermatocytic tumor, which is also